Taking drama, the phrase drama for your mama, to a whole new level from MTV's teen mom, an original teen mom. Amber Portwood is here with her fiancé, Matt Baier. Nice to see you both.
Nice to see you guys.
So, these shows are very dramatic, but you tell me, you took a swing at somebody else who was trying to flirt with Matt? Is that what happened? No?
It took us...
That was years ago.
Okay. A misunderstood swing. Well, let me ask you this. Both of you guys have written, is it fair to describe them as advice books?
I would say not advice books. I would say more memoirs.
Memoirs.
Advice books. But there's a lot to learn in them, especially from hers.
Mine's definitely more of a, just to show what I've been through at such a young age and to help others, to help addicts and people who've been in jail, and how to show them that they can, you know, become, you know, a better person.
Your book is called Never Too Late.
Yes.
You had a child at 18.
Yes.
Daughter, son.
I had a daughter.
Daughter who's 8 now.
Yeah.
And so in this, what's the takeaway from the book?
Pretty much anybody that reads it, you're going to get a lot of knowledge through things that maybe you've been through, maybe you haven't. And it's really the reason why I wrote it. I think I'm the only one that's only wrote one book, actually. The reason why I wrote it is because I wanted people to have faith in themselves, because when I was in prison, you know, I taught 150 women. I became head facilitator of the CLIF program. And, you know, I just wanted to give people hope, you know, that either your mother or you, whoever's going through it, or if you know somebody, that there's a light at the end of the tunnel, not to be cheesy, but there really is. You just have to work hard for it, and that's what I did.
How did you turn it around? Was there something?
I worked hard. I made a decision.
Ultimately?
Yes, there was. I was in drug court, and I was also on house arrest, and I was chewing fentanyl patches. Like, that's what Prince died from, I believe. They can't detect it unless they lab it. So in there, it's, you know, nothing. And I just woke up one day. I hadn't seen my daughter, I think, in 2 months. And I was terrified. And I walked into court, because we go to court every week when we were in drug court. And I said to the judge, I would like to opt out of drug court. And they took that as me opting out of rehab, but it wasn't. It was putting myself in a situation where I didn't have control of myself, because I couldn't. So sometimes you have to do things like that as a person to get to a better place in your life. And I think people should have more courage to do things. I'm not saying put yourself in jail or prison, but at least have the courage to put yourself in rehab or get help or seek help or talk to somebody in any way. But if you know you're at your bottom, either you're gonna live or die, which is where I was at the time.
Matt, you have a book as well. It is called You Have, and we took a word out, No Blank Idea. Successful career in radio, and then what happened?
Well, radio kind of died a little bit. And Amber and I met sometime later, and you know, we fell in love. And because Amber's life is completely documented, and I was part of it, then I ended up being part of this show. And ended up writing the book because I became the target of a lot of online rumors and gossip. And everybody wanted to fill in the rest of my life and my past for me. And so I finally decided to step up and say, listen, here's the truth.
The real story.
This is what my past is. And again, I'm also a former addict. And so my past wasn't great. But I wanted people to know the actual truth as compared to people making up the truth.
Our helicopter reporter's on to something, so I'll tell people quickly that the show airs on MTV on Monday nights. Both books are out now. Thank you both.
Thank you guys so much for having us.
We appreciate it.
Thank you.